Pick, who is going to introduce our video and is going to narrate the video that we have to show to the committee, please.
Okay. Ma'am, I need for you to go to the podium.
And Ms. Pick is an attorney as well. Thank you.
If you would tell us your name and your position, please.
So I'm Jackie Pick, and I'm here as a volunteer. I am a lawyer, but I'm not acting as a lawyer in this case. I'm just helping out the legal team here. And going to explain to you the evidence that we have from State Farm Arena here in Fulton County, which goes to what Ray was talking about in terms of fraud or misrepresentation. So when that cues, okay. So it's going to be tough because I'm going to have to depart from the microphone and point out some things at times. You're looking at one big room here. This is where, according to our witnesses who have given us sworn affidavits, this is where the absentee ballots and military ballots are being tabulated on election day. So we have the tape from first thing in the morning all the way past the close of the polls. What you have is essentially two Republican field organizers who were sent here to be observers. At no time were they actually permitted to observe in a meaningful way. I'm sorry, I have a voice issue today. They are roped off with the press on the side.
See if I can show you.
Yes, it is.
Keep your eyes right here.
Okay. Tell you what you could do to help us out so that everyone can hear who's live streaming. If you would tell us what you're going to point to and then go point to it.
Okay.
All right.
So now what will happen is these frames can move around. So this can get a little confusing, but I'll make sure to make it clear. We have two observers there that are going to show up, not at this point, this is in the morning, as you can see the daylight. They're going to get there at about 8 o'clock to watch the tabulation of absentee and military ballots. But according to their affidavits, at about 10 o'clock, there was one person working the polls who told everyone in the room to leave on the basis they were going to stop counting and return at 8:30 in the morning. So if I can get the frame for approximately 10 o'clock or 10:20-ish.
10 p.m.
Okay. We'll have to come back to the morning for a different reason in just a second. Okay, so you can see what time it is. So we're at about 10 o'clock. And what you'll notice is that the workers are present, working. And you have, back in that corner I pointed out to you, the press and the Republican observers. So according to the witnesses, the Republican observers, there is a lady who has blonde braids who comes out to announce, "We're going to stop counting. Everyone go home." And in fact, we see that. What happens is everyone clears out, including the Republican observers and the press, but four people stay behind and continue counting and tabulating well into the night from that point, which is going to be about 10:25 when they all clear out, or 10:30. And they will continue counting unobserved, unsupervised, not in public view as your statute requires, until about 1 in the morning. The reason we know this is because when our Republican observers were forced to leave, they went to the Central Tabulation Center and they got news from word from a news crew that in fact counting had continued. They have information that not everybody left according to plan and some people stayed behind. So this shocked them. So they returned back to State Farm Arena at about 1 o'clock in the morning, where they confirmed that in fact people had just left State Farm Arena in contravention of what they had been told by the supervisors who are running this operation. So, okay, we're still at about 10 o'clock. Can you take us to about 10:25, so we can see the change. You're going to watch this place be busy and filled up to emptied at some time between 10:25 and 10:35, which is consistent with what the affidavits say. Okay, so 10:25, they're still there. Let's go to 10:35. It takes it just a few minutes for the frames to actually catch up with it. There you go, with the time that you're seeing. So here you see it's all cleared out. We just went from 10:25 to 10:37. The place is a ghost town. This is where the people were vacated and told, go home, come back at 8:30. We will now stop working and stop counting. But notice who stays behind. You have four people, consistent with our affidavits, who stayed behind. And so you'll see the lady in purple. You'll see two women in yellow in the back, which is where the scanners are there at the top, top right frame. And then the lady with the blonde braids also, who told everyone to leave. Those are the four people who will stay behind. So the Republican observers said they were the last people to leave State Farm Arena, along with the Fox News crew, excepting those four people. So what you're going to see, look at the ladies in yellow. You'll see that they will begin just sitting still, doing nothing, ostensibly not working, because after all, they said they're going to stop counting. They will wait until the witnesses over there in that roped off area, the press and the observers, leave the room. Then you'll see them move into action and begin scanning ballots. Okay, so I think what we can do now is fast forward to about 11. Do you see them? Yeah. Okay, there they walk. They're walking off. But the ladies in yellow are still there. Yes, keep your eyes on the lady in purple and the two in yellow and the woman in the blue apron with blonde braids, because those are the people who stay behind. Okay, so what you're going to see happen at about 11 o'clock is once everyone is gone, coast is clear, they are going to pull ballots out from underneath a table. Watch this table. So actually this will take a few minutes, but we did not know when we first watched this, okay, is it normal to store suitcases of ballots under a table, under a tablecloth? Is that how they run the place? Maybe this is what they've been doing all day. Maybe this is what they're doing under all the tables. So we went back and watched the video as a team of us. We don't see that. What we see is typically you're going to find ballots, you know, back in this corner or coming in through a door, and then they get moved and circulated throughout the room. And it can get a little confusing because they have these black containers of ballots. They have the U.S. Postal Service containers. But what we were trying to do when we determined that there were ballots being pulled out from underneath this table is, you know, what was the chain of custody? Where did they come from? Who put them there? When did they put them there? We only reviewed this at about 1 in the morning last night for a couple of hours, so we're going to need about 14 hours to watch it carefully because we fast-forwarded through it several times and could not find that particular frame, but here's what we can tell you for sure. At about 8 o'clock in the morning, we're going to roll this back and show it to you. There you go. So now they're going to start pulling these ballots out from under this table. This table, the black one, was placed there by the lady with the blonde braids at about 8:22 a.m. in the morning. So she put that table there. So the same person who's staying behind now, the same person who cleared the place out under the pretense that we're going to stop counting, is the person who put the table there at 8:22 in the morning. Yeah, I saw four suitcases come out from underneath the table. Yeah, upper right hand. You see the gentleman in the red. So he just pulled one out. So what are these ballots doing there, separate from all the other ballots? And why are they only counting them whenever the place is cleared out with no witnesses? Is the question. So these machines can process about 3,000 ballots an hour. You have multiple machines there, and they're there for 2 hours. So you do the math. How many ballots went through those machines in those 2 hours when there was no one there to supervise, to be present, consistent with your statutes and rules, to supervise the tabulation? We believe that could easily be, and probably is certainly, beyond the margin of victory in this race. Because if it's only three scanners working for 2 hours, right, that's 18,000 ballots that went through. So we're now at 1109. There were, in addition to the four workers that you see there, there were two other people who were bringing ballots in and out. The gentleman in red that you saw, and then a second person, I can't tell if it's a male or female based on their hair being pulled back in their mask, but in any event, that's six total people. And so if we were to sit here for the next 2 hours, what we would see is that this operation just goes on and on and on. They're scanning until about 12:55 in the morning. So we kept the video running. And you know, we can show you the people who gave us the affidavits reappearing at that time, just as they said, around 1 a.m. to find out, are they in fact counting after they told us they would stop working or not? And we will fast forward to that, but have you all seen as much as you'd like to see of what's happening here?
I think so.
I think you basically get the idea.
Unless any member wants to see more.
Or you have any questions?
No. No, let's go ahead.
Okay. So let's fast forward to about 12:55 in the morning. Okay, so it's updated to 12:50. You can see these people are still there, up in the upper right-hand corner. Basically, they've wrapped up. This is the end of their operation. They've now completed about 2 hours of unsupervised tabulation of ballots. So now you're going to watch them leave. And let's fast forward to, let's go to 1:30. I think it's between 1:30 and 1:45 is when our two witnesses come back. They had to fight through security to get in there, but they did. And they say in their affidavits that two different people affirm for them that people have been counting from, you know, 10:30 when they cleared out until about approximately 5 minutes before they arrived. And they have the names of those people who told them that. Okay, now we're looking at, what is that, 1:42 in the morning. Is there a way to fast forward a bit or make it go a little faster? Okay, there are our guys right there in the lower left-hand corner. So they've now returned to State Farm Arena, having heard from the press that they had continued counting because they wanted to see for themselves if that was really happening, which was a complete contradiction to what they had been told by at least one person from Fulton County, who's an employee and spokesperson, and also the lady in the blonde braids we spoke about earlier. And so they see for themselves. And from this, we get the affidavit. I don't know the name of the lady in the blonde braids. They simply gave a description to us, and you can make out clearly who she is based on the people in the film. Lady in the blonde braids, halfway down her back, is the person who yelled out, "Everyone leave and stop counting." I believe Ms. Waller is the spokesperson for Fulton County Elections, who remained behind. The other two people, they don't have names for. They just said they were older women, and one of them had the name Ruby across her shirt somewhere. And that's as much as they know about who those people were. So our guys go in, they look around, they ask a few questions, and they leave. It is from their affidavits that we even knew to ask about this. And you might recall that the press reported there was like a supposed water break or water main break or pipe break or whatever, and that this was an excuse for people clearing out of State Farm Arena. It's not clear from the affidavits I saw whether or not that was the reason given by the election official or whether they gave any reason at all. They just said, "Stop, we're leaving. We'll be back at 8:30. So I don't know if that was a play here or not. Okay, can we back up to 8:22 a.m. in the morning, same frames, because we wanted to know, when did that table get put there? Who put it there? When did the ballots get put there? Who put it there? Okay, so 8:21, you'll notice the table's not there at all. Here it comes. There's the table going in that we're talking about where the ballots were obscured. That lady who's moving it is the lady with the blonde braids. She's dressed differently in the morning, so it took us a while to figure out that's the same person that you see at night with the blue apron on, who's yelling for everyone to leave and who stays behind to help tabulate ballots after they've all left. So I can see that she's the one who chose to place that table there, close to the scanners. And so the video is still under review. We need to spend hours reviewing carefully how those ballots got there. But we can tell you that it appears to be an aberration from how the other ballots were handled in that room throughout that day. So that's the gist of it. Do you have any questions?
Any questions, Senator D?
Fulton County Chairman Rob Pitts testified in a committee earlier today that the water break occurred